Hey guys, this is Karu Boys, and in our last video we discussed what is the basic requirement and what is the dependency to create your dev environment. And in this video we are going to discuss how to set up your first Angular application. And I am going to use Visual Code Studio for this. So this is my integrated terminal provided by Visual Code Studio, so I can check open by view and the terminal. So this is the folder where I want to create my first Angular application. So what is the command for creating your first Angular application is like ng, then new, and then the app name. My app. So it again asks me some instruction. So I'm just going to press enter whatever the default configuration is there. And it will take some time to download all the dependency. So all the dependency is downloaded. Now I'm going to inside that my project folder, cd my app, and I can import my folder from the file also, file and then the open folder. So this is my Angular app and then my app. So now what I am going to do is I am just going to simply run my Angular application. So I'll again go to terminal and going to type ng serve. So when you're able to see terminal show you compile successfully command means your application is built successfully. And now you can check your application on browser. So localhost 4200. So this is my Angular application running successfully. Now what we are going to do is we are going to go through the folder structure on Angular application. What is the component? What is the root module of this application? And what the things Angular provided us. So let's go to source folder SRC. So this is the place where all the things are available. On package.json, you're able to see all the dependency required for your first Angular application is available inside this package.json. So if you want to add more dependency on your application, you can define here. And what is the root module of your application? So you can go to app folder and app.module.ts. So this is the place, this is the main module of your application. So whatever the services, component, pipes you are creating in your application, you have to define here. And if you go to app.component.ts, this is the first component created by Angular. So we'll go through all the things written over here in the later video. In this video, we are just going to know the basic structure of our application. So you can see here the explode port class is app component and the selector is app root. And in the app module.ts, we are bootstrapping our app controller and we have imported our app component from here. And if you go to index.html, the app root selector is defined here. So when your Angular application loads, it go to app module.ts and it will compile all the dependency written over there, and then it load the HTML pages and it look for the app.root I have to run. So it go to app component.ts and whatever the template and style we have defined here, it's going to show on your browser. So what is the template URL we are using? app.component.html. So I'm just going to remove all this thing from here, UL and then h2 and then this image, and now move to your browser. So let's save our template file and move to browser. I reload the application. You're able to see only welcome to my app. So now where this my app is coming, so in the h1 tag you see the static message is welcome to and title is binded with. So where this title property coming? The title is coming from the app component.ts and where we have defined our title is myapp. So let's change this. We are going to initialize Q-A-R-U-E, Karu. Let's save this and go back to your browser. So you're able to see welcome to Karu. So thanks for watching this video guys. In our next video, we'll going to discuss about component.